So student, just we were finding in the example of the given table x oblique y, where x has the values 1, 2 and 3 and y has the values 1 and 2. Respective probabilities, that means joint probabilities, were given by this one 0.1, 0.2, 0.4, 0.2, 0.1 and 0. And the question was, we have seen how to find out probability of x plus y greater than 2 and probability of x plus y less than 4. Now let us see how to find out marginal probability. That means find marginal probability of x. So here marginal probability of x is to be find. That means we have to find out for each values of x, that means for x equal to 1, x equal to 2, x equal to 3. So this has the formula. We have seen f1x equal to sigma f of xy for all y, because here y is kept fixed. X is kept fixed and y varying. That means y runs over every values of whichever is allotted for it. For example, here if we want to find out f1, 1 for x equal to 1, then we have this is f of 1 comma y for all y. So this is nothing but y equal to 1. So f of 1, 1. F of 1, 1 is 0.1 plus f of 1, 2. This is 0.2. So this is 0.3. Similarly, we can find out f1, 2. F1, 2 is sigma f of 2 comma y for all y. So now we can find out this as f of 2 comma 1. This is 0.4. F of 2 comma 2. This is 0.2. So 0.6. Similarly, we can find out f1, 3 in the same way. But here you can see we can also find the same values directly from the table, because f1x is nothing but the total of this one. 0.1 plus 0.2, that is 0.3. F12 is nothing but 0.4, 0.2, 0.6, and this is 0.1. So it has the answer 0.1. Similarly, we can find out marginal probability of y. Marginal probability of y is denoted by F2y equal to sigma f of xy. Here y is kept fixed, so it is run over x. So we have the values of y are 1 and 2. So we can find out F21 first. F21 is nothing but sigma f of 1 comma x comma 1 for all x. So here x has the values 1, 2 and 3. So first we will have f of x equal to 1, that means F11. X equal to 2, that means f of 21. X equal to 3, that means x3 comma 1. So F11 is what? Here you can see F11 is 0.1. Okay, plus F21 is what? 0.4. Plus F31 is what? 0.1. So this is it has the answer 0.1 plus 0.4, that is 0.5 plus 0.1, that is 0.6. And you can also see that these values we can also find by adding the values in the row. So it is the value 0.6, it is the value 0.4, 0.2 plus 0.2 plus 0. So we have f of 2 comma 2 equal to 0.4. So without doing this process also, we can find out from the table the values directly. So these are the marginal probabilities as required by us. Now we go for how to find conditional probability. That means the question, find out conditional probability of x given y equal to 1. So here the value of y is given. Value of y is kept fixed. So first of all, we will write out a formula. Here we want to find out conditional probability. Conditional probability of x. So we will denote this by f1. And as I told you that the probability based on y is denoted by f2. So here it is nothing but x by y. So y is known here y is known, that is y equal to 1. And this is nothing but f of x y divided by f2y. So f of x y are these probabilities given in the table. So now we find out for x equal to 1, then we find out for x equal to 2, then we can find out for x equal to 3. So if we want to find out for x equal to 1, we have f1 because y equal to 1 given y equal to 1. So this is nothing but x and y both are 1. So f1 divided by f2 1. So once again here you note that if we are asked to find out conditional probability, then and if we are not asked to find out marginal probability, however we are required to find out marginal probability because f2y is nothing but the marginal probability of y. So this is required. So here f of 1 comma 1 is 0.1 and f of 2 comma 1 is this value 0.6. So this is the value. Now similarly we can find out this for f of 2 by 1, that means f of 2 comma 1. And here you do not forget that x is written first and then y is written. So here x is 2, y is 1. And divided by f of 2, 1. So f of 2 comma 1, that means this value 0.4 divided by f of 2, 1, 0.6. And similarly you can find out f of 1 because these are related with f of 1. 3 by 1. You can find out this as f of 3, 1 divided by f of 2, 1. And you can do yourself this example. Similarly, if you are asked to find out the conditional probability of y given x equal to 2, suppose. Then in this case, we have the formula is f of 2 y by x. So, it is the conditional probability on y, so we are denoting this by f2, okay? So, this is nothing but f of x comma y divided by f1x. Here f2, so by mistakenly, it is possible to write down f2, but not write f2 because with the x, we are denoting this by f1. So, here again, marginal probability based on x are required. This is the must. So, here we have different values of y. Y is 1 and 2. So, we can find out f of 2, 1 by x. X is what? 2. This is fixed. Then we will find out f of 2, y is 2 and x is 2. This is fixed. So, this is f of 2 comma 1. See here, x is this value, y is this value. So, I have written this as 2 comma 1 divided by f1 2 by using this formula. X is 2. And this is the value f of 2 comma 2 divided by f1 2. So now we say that f of 2 comma 1 is 0.4. And divided by f1 2. What is f1 2? f1 2 is 0.6 here. 0.6. And similarly you can find out this value. So marginal probabilities we can find out for x on y and y on x by using this formulas. So, conditional probability, we can find out very easily. And you must have noted this one. So, once if we are given this kind of table, then our problem will become very simple. So, here we are asked to find out conditional probability of x or y. So, we have obtained this for each value of x. But sometimes you may be asked to find out conditional probability for some particular value of x. Then we will have to find out only that value. Not all other values. Okay. Now let us see another example. During the throw of two dice simultaneously, if capital X assumes the value on the first die, and Y assumes the value on second die. then find probability of capital X plus Y equal to 6 to probability of X equal to Y and 3 probability of X plus Y less than 4. So here you see that we are not given the joint distribution table. That means we are not given the value of f of x, y for all x and y, because here we have x as the value 1, 2, 3 up to dot 6 and y as the values 1, 2, 3 dot 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 6. So if we want to construct the table, it will give us 6 by 6 size table. Okay, but we can see, we will have to find out the probabilities for each x and y. But we know that it is the case of throwing a two dice. So we know that the first any number on the first die, the probability of appearing any number either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6 is 1 by 36. And same probability we can have when it to get a number, any number on 1 by 6. It is 1 by 6 and it is 1 by 6, so the total probability is 1 by 36. That is, for every value of x and y, the probability will be same in this case, and it is 1 by 36. So we don't require to construct the table because we can identify this one very easily. So now our question is to find out probability of capital X plus Y equal to 6, and that means we want to find out the probability when these two the sum is gives us 6. So this happens when x equal to 1 and y equal to 5, when x equal to 2 and y equal to 4, when x equal to 3 and y equal to 3, when x equal to 4 and y equal to 2, and when x equal to 5 and y equal to 1. And we know that every values are 1 by 36 and we can get the required answer. Similarly, for the second one, probability of x equal to y, that means if both are equal to 1, that means then this happens when x equal to y. So f of 1, 1, f of 2, 2, plus f of 3, 3, plus dot, 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 f of 6, 6. And this also you can find out very easily by putting their values 1 by 36. And likewise, you can solve this example, capital X plus y less than 4. That means the two values of x and y should be less than 4. That means it can be 1, 2 or 3, whatever it is, and you can solve this this part very easily. And here I am telling you that you must solve each and every example in this here yourself. You must practice, you must get practice yourself. Now let us see another example, the joint probability distribution. Joint probability distribution is given in the following table. Capital X and capital Y, it has the values 0, 1 and 2. Y has the values 1 and 2. The respective probabilities, joint probabilities, are given by 2k, 3k, k, 4k, 4k and 2k, and then the question is to find out the value of k. Here we can find out the value of k very simply. The simple logic is there, because we know that the summation of all the joint probabilities for all x and for all y is always equal to 1. That means we have 2k plus k plus 4k plus 3k plus 4k plus 2k equal to 1. And by using this, we can find out the value of k. You can do this yourself, because this is the very simple task for you. So don't hesitate, and you can solve this example very simply. Okay? Now, let us see another example, which is very much important to understand, because if you will understand this example, then you will come to know each and everything in all other examples. Here the question is that a bag contains 4 white, 2 red, 3 black balls. Let X, capital X, be the number of red balls, and Y be the number of black balls. If two balls are drawn at random, then find the joint probability distribution. So here again the question is very simple. We want to find out the joint probability distribution. So we are given X is the number of red balls. So you must write down X the number of red balls here. And then write down that X has the values it may possess. There may be, because we want to draw two balls, and the red balls are 2. So it can be 0, 1 or 2. And Y has the values, because Y denotes the number of black balls. There are 3 black balls, so it can be 0, 1, 2, 3. So we want to construct a table of this type, X by Y. See, joint probability distribution only we want to find out. That means we want to find out the tabular values. We don't want to find out here marginal probability or conditional probability. If we are first marginal probability or conditional probability, we can do it very easily. So X has the values 0, 1 and 2, and Y has the values 0, 1, 2 and 3. So we will find out values for each of the values of X and Y. So first of all, we find out F of 0, 0. That means here probability of getting no ball is red or black. Now finally we have selected 2 balls at random, so there is no red and no black ball. That means it must be from white ball. So the white ball can be selected, 2 balls can be selected in 4 situations, divided by, there are total balls, 4 plus 2 6 plus 3 9. So 9C2, this is the probability. And 4C2 is what? 4 into 3 divided by 2, as I explained to you in the last lecture. And this is nothing but 9 into 8 divided by 2. So 2 and 2 will be cancelled, 4 2 is this, 3 3 is this. So 1 by 3. So we can put this value over here. Similarly, we can find out f of 1, 0, this value, 1, 0. So 1, 0 can be obtained. That means 1 is related with red ball. So probability of getting 1 red, 0 black. 0 black means the another ball must be white. So 1 white ball. So this probability can be obtained as white ball can be drawn in 4C1 ways, and 1 red ball can be chosen in 2C1 ways, and divided by 9C2. So this is nothing but 4 into 2. Divided by 9 into 8 divided by 2. So we have 4 plus 8. So this is 2 by 9. So its probability is 2 by 9. And then we will find out f of 2, 0. F of 2, 0, that means probability, that is 2 red balls. 2 red balls here. And 2 red balls can be selected from 2 red balls in 2C2 ways. And divided by 9C2. So 2C2 is 1. And 9C2 is 9 into 8 divided by 2. So this is nothing but 2 4s are 1 by 36. So its value is 1 by 36. Okay. Similarly, we can find out f of 0, 1. F of 0, 1 is probability of finding 1 black ball. And no zero ball. No zero ball means one ball must be white. So this can be obtained as one white ball is selected in 4C1 ways, and one white ball, black ball can be selected in 3C1 ways divided by 9C2, and you can find out its value. Then we will find out f of 1, 1. 1, 1 means probability of getting one red ball and one white ball. One red ball and one black ball. One red ball can be selected in 2C1 ways, and this can be done in 3C1 ways. So divided by 9C, 2. You can also find this one. Then we will find out f of 2,1. F of 2,1 means probability of getting two red balls and one black ball. But see here, it gives us three balls to choose. It says that three balls have to be chosen, but actually we are selecting only two random balls. So it is not possible. So it is impossible event. It is impossible event. So its probability is always equal to 0. Similarly, we can find out f of 0,3. Its probability will be 0, because again there will be three balls will be selected. So this will be this is impossible event. 1,3 will also be 0. 2,3 will also be 0. This is 0. So the other values you can find out. And also you can verify all these values by adding them, because their total should be 1. Their total must be equal to 1. You can find out and you can verify this one very easily. So this is the required probability, joint probability distribution which we wanted. And you can stop over here. But if you are asked with the same to find out marginal probabilities, no need for further calculation, because you can sum up these values. You can find out this total. These are the marginal probabilities on Y, and the marginal probabilities on X can be obtained in this way. Okay. So it is very clear and very simple, because every year one example may be asked in your examination, and you can solve these examples very easily. Okay, thank you.